Hi everybody, I'm Sam Feifel, editor of sparpointgroup.com. Welcome to Spar Vlog. This week, I am, like seemingly everyone on the internet, intrigued by the three patents recently published by Apple, having to do with 3D imaging. The most germane is one titled Image Capture Using Three-Dimensional Reconstruction. As you might expect, this has everyone buzzing about the iPhone 5 having a 3D camera on board next time it comes out. So what does using three-dimensional reconstruction mean to Apple? Well, this is definitely not just the stereo 3D camera that you can get on some Android phones. The patent makes clear that part of the system would be a processing module for deriving depth information using at least two images, which sounds a whole lot like your basic photogrammetry. Also, the patent mentions detailed geometric information and being able to reproduce the three-dimensional shape of the objects. Clearly, that's not just stereo. So it would seem we're talking about something similar to 123D Catch here, but self-contained in the iPhone or iPad. Basically, scan the model instantaneously, which would be pretty rad. The other two patents hint at what you would actually do this for. They relate, respectively, to placing an asset on and integrating an asset with three-dimensional models. So tack on the associated photo, and you can see that they're talking about having you scan your head, make it into your avatar, and then be able to mess around with it, which, again, sounds kind of cool. It'll be like making a me on the Wii, but even cooler, and looking even more like you. People have even speculated that the cops could use something like this to create wanted posters for known criminals that would have them dressed in different ways that they might actually be disguised, so you could pick them out. Really, there's any number of potential applications that you could see using this for. But you don't need to wait for the iPhone 5. I'll tell you why right after this word from our sponsors.
Gosh, Kent, it was so smart of you to strap your Laser Blaster 9 million to our Mini and create a mobile scanning system. How did you think of it?
Well, last year I went to the SPAR International Conference in Houston, and they had like 9 vehicles parked out front, and you could check out all the different systems that were possible. So I examined all the hardware and looked at all the best systems, and I made a really smart decision about what technology to use.
But Ken, do you think there's enough demand in the market? How do you make the business case?
Well, that's the best thing about SPAR International. It's not just the technology. You also have more than 100 presenters. And so I went to the mobile scanning track, and I learned all kinds of things about the ROI of a scanning system and how to make the business case to end users like departments of transportation that need these services. I really have my plan down, and I'm going to hit the ground running, and I'm going to have a profitable enterprise for us, Barbie.
You're so smart, Kent. You should go to SPAR every year.
Okay, you're coming to SPAR, right? I mean, Barbie would be really disappointed if you didn't go. I can assure you of that. Anyway, the reason you don't have to wait for Apple is because designer Isaac Blankensmith has created the Armada 3D scanner, which looks like this, and hooks up directly to your iPhone via Bluetooth. I mean, this thing is gorgeous. It's got twin 18 megapixel cameras on the outside and a Class 2 laser on the inside. Put it all together and you get an instant 3D model of whatever you happen to wave this thing around. It builds an STP file on your phone, and then you can download it or email it wherever you want. It's more than a little impressive. Just Google 3D Armada laser scanner and you'll find it in about 5 seconds. Or you can find the link probably on the page on sparpointgroup.com where this is posted. Again, there's a question of what you might actually want to do with this thing. What's the accuracy? What's your workflow if you want to use it for reverse engineering? Can you get to NURB surfaces, etc.? Those are things that you need to figure out on your own at this point. But you can put this together with the likes of what Matterport are doing with a modified Kinect scanner, and you can see that the price point for creating a point cloud from small objects in short-range scanning environments is going to start coming way, way down. The possibilities for that are pretty exciting. What would you scan? How would you use the information? And what could you do now that you couldn't do before? Think about that until the next installment of SPAR Vlog, and I'll see you next time. Thanks for watching.